Thanks, Brett. So my name is Mark Strassman. I head up our plant and construction groups. Some of you know me from, 8 or 9 years back when I was in charge of the AutoCAD business. 4 or 5 years ago, we broke off a separate group to focus on construction, focus on plant rather. Just this past year, we broke off a whole separate group to focus on construction. So not gonna be talking about plant today. We're actually not launching the new 2012 plant products this quarter. We'll be launching those soon, and so we'll talk to you about those then. So today, focusing on construction. Also have Scott Johnson up here, who's going to be showing some of the products. First, I want to give you, just talk a little bit about the construction market. You've heard about it today from Jay, you've heard about it from Jim. You're gonna hear about it from me. I figure as you're heading down right before the sugar hits you, I'm gonna get you as the sugar's rising before you plummet again for the end of the day. So, as you can tell, we're very serious about construction. It's a really interesting market in a bunch of ways. It's a big market undergoing a lot of transformations, and there's a lot of new technologies that are really addressing some of these transformations. So a big market. Construction accounts for about 10% of the world GDP. Just an enormous market. A lot of money being spent there. At the same time, of that 10% of the GDP, about 30% of construction costs are attributed to waste. And that's just the way it is. It's the way that construction jobs have been planned for a long time. The wrong materials show up at the wrong time. There are clashes. You have to order different materials. There's subcontractors sitting on site waiting for different materials to show up, and you got to change your whole schedule. So waste is just part of the process, and it's just the way it's been. But, you know, again, 10% of the world's economy, 30% of that is waste. Huge opportunity to get more productivity and more profits. Big change that's going on now is contractors are really leading the value chain. The value chain is changing. It used to always start with the designers, be passed over the wall through the engineers to the construction process. The recession has really changed a lot. A lot of consolidation, design build firms, contractors are now starting to do, raise the bonds, start to actually fund these projects, public-private partnerships. So the contractors leading the value chain in a way they never did before. So this 30% waste is particularly acute. That said, some technologies are really addressing this 30% waste in a way they haven't before. All day you've heard about BIM, about the building information model. It's not just about design, it's about extending beyond design. And the real beneficiaries of all this information in the building information model are the contractors. The cloud. Having all this building information in the cloud as opposed to trapped on a desktop or trapped on a server in someone's office give accessibility in the field to the contractor in a way they never have before. And then mobile. We hear from, every contractor's got, all of us have devices. Every contractor in the field has a device. Met with a contractor a couple weeks ago. They said, I was on a job site. I needed to find information about a change going on in the project. One of my subs brought it up right in his device. He said, we didn't have access to that. We had to go down to the shop, get our huge paper documents that weren't up to date. It took an hour and a half to find it. We need access to the information in the field. So mobile devices, BIM, and the cloud give access to the things contractors care about in a way they've never had access before. What they really care about, they care about the cost, the schedule, and the constructability. Constructability, how it all goes together. Schedule, obviously what comes after what, how long it takes to build, and that all affects the cost. So BIM, cloud, and mobile allow access to all of these in a way they never have before. And that's what we're really focused on. I'm not gonna read this. This is really the mission of my group. But it's really about allowing contractors to win projects with a lot more predictability, cutting out the waste, and a lot less risk. I met with a contractor recently. They said, you know why they call us contractors, right? I said, actually, no, I hadn't really thought about it. They manage all the contracts to get the building built to reduce risk. So they really see themselves as risk mitigators, and BIM gives them the insight into that. So where do we see the industry going? We really want to cut out that 30% waste. We want to give contractors the ability to go from waste to predictability on projects. Every contractor we talk to is interested in BIM to go from waste to real predictability. We hear from a lot of contractors that the old process is design, bid, build, going over the fence from process to process. They really see themselves going to a manufacturing process. The more they can manufacture off-site, bring it on-site, and bolt it onto a manufacturing process, the more productivity they get. So more and more fabrication. Talk more about that. And then going from desktop to anywhere. These contractors, you know, they might have, you know, a PC in the job site trailer, but they need the information anywhere to see something's changing on site, to compare something as designed with the actuals, to get information about how things were built and get it back in the system. It's about getting the information anywhere. And lastly, going from information to knowledge. You know, BIM, the I in BIM is from information. And project to project, there's huge amounts of productivity we can bring to the project, giving that insight into information. However, from project to project, you can turn that information into knowledge, knowing how long it took to build something, knowing how many clashes there were on a site and where they were. Take that information over time, give insight into it, to give insight into future schedules, future estimations, and so forth. So I talked about where we're going, but we've got, you know, thousands, tens of thousands of customers that are using BIM today and are using it effectively, that are starting their own BIM groups to give more information to the insight, more insight and information into the model and their building process. So a bit of an eye chart on a few of these, but this is one way about how we look at BIM. You have structure, architecture, MEP, civil, all going into a multidisciplined BIM model. Out of that BIM model, you can get your documentation, you can do visualization, you can do quantification, counting things in the model that can go into estimating systems. You can use that model for fabrication, choosing what areas you want to fabricate and go into a fabrication process. You can use that BIM model for coordination, how the different disciplines come together, where clashes are. You can start doing 4D sequencing, time, what comes after what in the whole process. That can hook up your scheduling systems. And all of this hooking into the back-end systems. Construction companies are more and more of a manufacturing process, so hooking into the ERP systems, knowing the specifications, the schedules, the materials. It wasn't long ago that people really thought about Autodesk, especially in AEC, really as the design space, right? We have the design products for structure, for architecture, for MEP. And you saw today all the new features in our various design products. Revit architecture, Revit structure, Revit MEP, Civil 3D, all the things they do to give more insight into the building process. Several years ago, we introduced Navisworks, allowing customers to bring together all the different disciplines, not just from different Autodesk design tools, but from dozens, supporting dozens of formats. From that, offering visualization out of Max. Documentation, you saw today some looks at AutoCAD WS. So being able to, in the field, look at the 2D documents. Quantification. Last year, we introduced Autodesk QTO, quantity takeoff. So counting things, hooking into estimation systems. We're seeing a lot of customers use Inventor for fabrication, and Inventor Publisher Mobile for on-site instructions, how things go together. Coordination 4D sequencing, also done in Navisworks. So this is really about, in construction, extending BIM beyond design. We think we've got great design tools in this space, and we're really pushing BIM further and further there, but taking it beyond design. The contractors don't really care about the design. They care about the information and all the information they can get out of this model for quantification, fabrication, coordination, and so forth. And guess what? All these products, you knew you'd hear about suites again, right? They're all in the suite. So we have Navisworks Manage, AutoCAD, Revit Family. This is the ultimate suite that Jim showed you about. And this addresses all the different parts of the construction process. Things that aren't in the suite that are part of the construction process include Vault, Buzzsaw, and ConstructWare for data management through construction management. All important parts of the process. So given that, I'm going to go into just a little bit overview about some of the features in some of these products. And then Scott is going to go and give you a full demo. So construction modeling, you've heard about that a lot today. I heard about Revit with a division of objects and assemblies for greater level of detail for construction. So, you know, the way the architect might design a model doesn't care about where the studs are or, you know, how many square feet of concrete you need. That's the sort of thing that the BIM groups and the contractors are starting to put this level of detail in there. In Navisworks, interoperability, extended support for Revit. We have 2D DWIF and FBX support. There's Vault support in Navisworks, and you'll see that interoperability as well. And then extended support for third parties, APIs, and so forth. On the planning and analysis, done a lot of work on clash detection, ability to report clash detection. Can do more Gantt charting, exporting out Excel spreadsheets to bring into various scheduling tools. Cost estimation, show you some things we're doing in QTO. Project management, really doubling down on constructware and the things we're doing in constructware, specifically making constructware more applicable for BIM. So we have embedded the Navisworks viewer. So you can do your clash reports, you can assign clashes to different users, new feature in Navisworks, and then assign them and view them right here in constructware. Additionally, we added a API to Outlook, so we can integrate with Exchange servers. So when people are assigned tasks in constructware, they can actually get emailed about it. So fitting in their workflow, you know, combining that 2D or you know, even email-based workflow with a BIM model. And then collaboration. You heard about BIM 360. Integrating there and things we're doing across the collaboration to bring all these different parties from design through field into the construction process. So with that, I want to introduce Scott Johnson. He'll show you all this great stuff. Thanks.
Thanks, Mark.